Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. My name is Engineer Vakas Haroon. Today the topic is about the elements of the vertical curve design. In this lecture, I will tell you how can you design the curve by achieving the elevation at a specific location. For this, let's solve the example. This example has been taken from the book Principles of the Highway Engineering and Traffic Analysis written by Fred L. Mendring. So let's start the example. An equal tangent vertical curve is to be constructed between the grades of -2% and 1%. The PVI is at station 1110 and at elevation 420 feet. Due to street crossing the roadway, the elevation of the roadway at station 1112 must be at 424.5 feet. Design the curve. So the given data is equal tangent vertical curve. And the next one is G1, that is -2%, that is initial roadway grade. And you can also denote it with small b. The next one is final roadway grade, that is G2. Stationing and the elevation of the point of the vertical intersection is given. Stationing of the PVI is 1110 and the elevation of the PVI is 420 feet. And the elevation of the roadway at a station 1112 is 424.5 feet is given. And you have to design the curve. It means you have to design the curve means you have to calculate all the stations and the elevations of the PVC and PVT, plus you have to calculate the required length of the curve to ensure that the station 112 must be at 424.5 feet. So you can see in this figure G1 and G2 is given, stationing and elevation of the PVC is not given, stationing of the PVA and the elevation of the PVA is given. And you have to calculate this stationing of the PVT and the elevation of the PVT, plus you have to calculate this required length. And the additional information is given that the street crossing the roadway at a stationing 1112 is 424.5 feet. So you can say that the distance of this point from the PVA point is 2 station. How can you calculate this distance? You can calculate this distance by calculating these values from this stationing of the PVA, that is 1110 feet, and the stationing of this crossing value, street crossing value, that is 1112 feet. The difference between the street crossing value and the PVA value is 2 stations. So you can say that the distance of this point from the PVC station is half of the curve length plus 2 stations. Initial grade, final grade, stationing of the PVA, elevation of the PVI, and distance between the PVA are given in our example. And you have to calculate the stationing of the PVC, elevation of the PVC, stationing of the PVT, elevation of the PVT, and the length of the curve. So first of all, we will calculate the stationing of the PVC. Stationing of the PVI is equal to the stationing of the PVC plus L by 2. This is the same equation that we have already used in our previous example, example number 1. You will simply put that values in the above equation, that is the stationing of the PVA is given, that is 1110 feet, and the stationing of the PVC, you have to calculate this value, plus L by 2. You can rewrite your equation, stationing of the PVC is equal to the 1110 minus L by 2. So to calculate this station of the PVC, you have to first calculate this value of the L. So the point is, how can you calculate this value of the L? You can calculate this value of the L by using the parabolic equation, that is y is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. But the point is, you first identify all the parameters so you can easily put that parameters in that equation. Here you already know that coefficient A is the difference, half of the difference between the roadway grades. In this case, G2 is 1 and G1 is -2. So the difference between the roadway grade is 1 minus minus 2 divided by 12. So you can say that the coefficient value is 1.5 divided by L. C is also known as the elevation of the PVC, and you already know that the elevation of the PVI is equals to the elevation of the PVC plus G percentage multiplied by the stationing between the PVC and PVI. This equation is you have already used in example number 1. You can directly put that values in this equation. Elevation of the PVA is given, that is 420 feet, and the elevation of the PVC you can denote it with small c, and the stationing between the PVC and the PVI, the value of G percentage is the grade present between the PVC and PVI. So in this case, the grade value is minus 2, and the stationing between the PVC and PVI value is L by 2. Why I have used this value L by 2? Because in our case, it is an equal tangent vertical curve. So in equal tangent vertical curve, you can easily write or you can easily use the value L by 2 for left hand side. Similarly, you can use L by 2 for the right hand side as well. So rearrange your equation, your final equation will become C is equals to 420 plus L. Value of G1 or value of B is already given in our case, and you are already known the what is the value of X. X is basically it is the point at which the street is crossing at a specific location, that is 0.5L plus into 2. You can directly put all the values in equation B, so your equation B will becomes 424.5L is equals to 1.5 into L plus minus into 2 plus 420 into L. Just solve that equation. After solving that equation, we will get two values. The first value is 13.467, or next value is 1.187. Now the point is which value you can be selected. 1.187 value cannot be selected because, as you already know, the distance between the PVI and the street crossing the roadway is 2 stations. So you cannot select the curve length that is less than 2 stations. So you will definitely select that value, that is 13.467. 13.446 station you can also write in feet, that is 1346.60 feet. So now you can calculate your stationing of the PVC. Stationing of the PVC, you have already made an equation, that is equation A. Simply put that value of L in equation A and you will get your required stationing, that is 103 plus 26.7. For elevation of PVC, you can simply use equation C, that is 420 plus L, putting the value of L 13.466, and you will get your required answer, that is 433.47 feet. Station of the PVT is equal to the station of PVA plus L by 2. Simply put the value of L in above equation and you will get your required stationing, that is 116 plus 73.3 feet. For elevation of PVT, you will use the equation elevation of a PVT is equal to the elevation of PVI plus G2. This G2 is the basically the grade that is present between the PVI and PVT, and this you will multiply that grade simply with the distance, or you can say that you can calculate the elevation of the PVT by using the slope equation formula. Elevation of the PVT is equal to the elevation of PVI that is given. You have already calculated, it is given in your example, elevation of PVA, that is 420 plus G2 is already given, that is 1, and you have already calculated this distance between the PVA and PVT. How you have calculated this value? Because you can say that this value is equal to the L by 2, and you have already calculated the value of L, just simply divided the value of L by 2 and you will get that value, that is 6.733. So your elevation of PVT is 426.733 feet. So in the last, the point is, how can you check your elevation values? So it is required to check the elevation of the curve at a station 112 is 424.5 feet or not. So you can check that by using the equation, parabolic equation y is equals to ax squared plus bx plus c. You can simply put the value of x, that is 0.5 l plus 2. You have already calculated the value of l, so your x value will becomes 8.733. You can easily calculate the coefficient value a, that is 0.111, and after putting the value of x and a in above equation, your y equation will becomes y is equals to 0.111, x is already given 8.733, plus the value of b is given, that is minus 2 8.733 plus 433.47. So you will get your required answer, that is 424.5 feet. So you can say that you have confirmed that the calculated and the required values are same. So it ensures that you have calculated all the correct values and your answer is right. Thank you.